Let's see if anyone tunes in. Hello, my live and replay viewers. Welcome to the World Trade Center. I'm going to show you something quite amazing. Just going to let a few more people into the room. Share this out, tweet this out with friends. Tell me where you're watching from. This is going to be an amazing scope, people. All right, Jim just tuned in from Long Island. Look at number one World Trade Center, looking amazing. I'm doing great. Tell me where you're watching from, give you a shout out. I want to show you something totally amazing. It's going to be beautiful. It may even make you cry. It almost made me cry just now, taking the Instagram pictures. So, Buenos Aires, Argentina. Thanks for tuning in, Buenos Aires. Got Jim tuned in from Long Island. Thanks for tuning in, Jim. Welcome to the World Trade Center. So here we have, I'm the guy from Russia. Do you remember me? There's so many people from Russia, but thanks for tuning in, Russia. So many people from Russia tune in all the time. So earlier this morning on Twitter, I saw that one of the trees here in the Memorial Plaza is blooming. Now, that's a survivor tree. And I got off from work today because it was raining. So I decided to pack up my camera, rush down here and take pictures. I'm kind of teasing you guys right now. Let's look back up at number one World Trade Center. It's looking amazing today. Neighbors are doing good over here in Russia. So the Memorial Plaza comprises of around 273 white swamp oak trees, but the survivor tree has a really special story. Hello from Belgium. Hello from France. Hello from Ireland. Thanks for tuning in, guys. You are looking at the survivor tree. The survivor tree is a peach tree that survived the collapse of both twin towers of the World Trade Center. Norway in the house. Thanks for tuning in, Norway. So many Europeans, yeah. As you see, the survivor tree is all by itself right now. It is blooming all by itself. It is so amazing. You're more than welcome for sharing. Today's going to be an entire day's worth of Periscope, so make sure to tune in. After this, we're going to go onto the Brooklyn Bridge. And then later on, we're going to watch, hopefully we'll watch sunset in Coney Island and take a ride on the cyclone. So you like this concept, dude. You're more than welcome. I am a licensed New York City tour guide, so please feel free to ask me questions about the World Trade Center, about New York in general. I'm here to transport you guys here, if you will. Had to rejoin. Okay, awesome. Well, I'm going to be here for a while. The broadcast just started. But this is a survivor tree. It was actually just over there in between the original number 4 and number 5 World Trade Centers. And, oh, yes. Thanks for following me. Thanks so much for following me. Yes, I got to show you guys. It was just right over there. And basically, it survived both collapses of the Twin Towers. It was nursed. Yes, I do have a Twitter account. Same name as my Periscope handle, DutchMazz, DutchMazz. Yes, it's a pear tree. It's a pear tree that managed to survive. They brought it up to Van Cortlandt Park. They nursed it back to health. And it went out to, thanks for sharing this on Twitter. Thanks so much. They brought it out to Van Cortlandt Park up in the Bronx, and they took it out to Pennsylvania. And yes, thank you so much, Ryan. And they nursed it back to health, and it was brought back over here a few years ago. But I saw this picture on Twitter this morning, and I was like, oh my God, I need to see this. Because I've seen pictures of it in the past, but you know, I kind of held off coming down here because it is kind of like a gaudy tourist attraction now. But you know, if I could show you guys this, then it's totally worth it coming down here. Thanks for inviting your followers. So I literally took the train an hour just to show you guys this and to take some Instagrams. You can go to my Instagram, same name as mine. You're more than welcome. Same name as my Periscope name, DutchMazz, DutchMazz. You can find me on Instagram and Twitter, Flickr, and YouTube. What time is it? I believe it's just past 2 o'clock, 2:25 Eastern Time, -5 GMT. So, yes, I will show you guys around here. So we'll start here. These two buildings here, these rather anonymous buildings, these are the pump houses for the memorial pools. Every minute, they recycled a little under 250,000 gallons of water a minute. That's equivalent to almost a quarter of the amount of water that goes over per minute over Niagara Falls. You might come over here to New York this summer. Awesome. I'll take you on a walking tour. Always private message me on Twitter. And we'll get something together, get something cooking. But here's number one World Trade Center, looking marvelous as always. And then here's number 7 World Trade Center. This number 7 World Trade Center is the only building built on the original footprint of its namesake. Directly in front of number 7 World Trade Center will be the World Trade Center Performing Arts Center. Yes, awesome. It'd be awesome to meet up. And currently, we're still waiting for an architect to build that building. We were going to have Daniel Libeskind do the design, but I don't know. That's kind of up in the air. Over in this direction over here, this will be where number 2 World Trade Center is. Number 2 World Trade Center was supposed to have Fox Broadcasting have its studios in there and whatnot, but they decided to pull out, and now the fate of number 2 World Trade Center is kind of up in the air, unfortunately. I see those white spikes over there. That's the transit hub. And we're going to go over there in a little bit because that building is too cool just to glaze over. Then here's the memorial. Here's the museum, the Entrance City Museum, which is underneath us. Here's number 3 World Trade Center, just past halfway tall. And as you can see the core of the building is taller than the actual floors right now. The core of the building is 2.5 meters thick reinforced concrete. So kind of amazing. Thanks for sharing this on Facebook. Here's number 4 World Trade Center, open, completed. The offices of the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey are in there today, and a couple other companies are in there. Designed by Fumaku Maki. And yes, he does. And that's kind of awesome. And now what we're going to do is we're going to walk right past the survivor tree right now. Yes, sharing me on all counts of social media. Yes, thank you. Let's take a walk underneath the tree here. It's such a treat to come out here and to show you guys this. You have no idea. This is what Periscope's all about. Not talking into the camera. Even though I do that every now and then, but let's take a walk around here. This is the South Tower Memorial, the pool here. Actually, it's kind of open over here, so. Look at this survivor tree, it looks so great. Hello from Dublin, Ireland. Thanks for tuning in, Dublin. Some people know about Periscope, some people don't know about Periscope. I gotta use it like to get people out of the way. That kind of works the best. Hello from Belgium. I took many a person from Belgium over the Brooklyn Bridge on my bicycle tours. Oh, look at this. This is why I brought you guys out here. And we're literally going to wander around here for the next about half hour. So here's the survivor tree. And then we look up. Look at that. Almost like fading into the sky, number 1 World Trade Center. It does look amazing. Okay, let's come over here. So this right here, where all this construction is, this is where Liberty Park's going to be. And Liberty Park is it's going to be an elevated park. And it connects, hello from the Ukraine. Yes, I'll show you the pool in a second. We'll get to the pool. But here, this park here is going to link up to the rebuilt Greek Orthodox Church, which was destroyed on 9/11. And that's another building designed by Santiago Calatrava, the same architect who did the transit hub. All right, so let's see the south pool here. And I'll describe to you how it works. Oh really? They show local time in the window. I didn't know that. The South Pool here. The weather in July kind of hot. So the panels here, the names here are arranged by either their company that they work for, or the floor and the company they work for. So it's usually clustered together like that with friends and coworkers. Ah, very cool. Normandy in the house. Thanks for tuning in, Normandy. Welcome to the World Trade Center. So, how it works here is, this is exactly on the footprint where the Twin Towers were, right? Exactly where it was. And you see how the names here rise to a point right here? I'm doing good, thank you very much. See how it rises right here to a point? This is where the wall would be. Thank you. Thanks for, yes, you'll be my number 1 avid follower. Thanks so much. More to come today. So this is where the wall would be, right here. right here where it comes to a point here. So kind of think of the memorial and where the names are kind of like a pedestal for the original Twin Towers. And then it goes into the void, 60 feet down, mind you. And I always like to say, never sit on the names, never lean on the names. And if you want to pay tribute, just run your names like this. Never take flowers from the names. I've seen people do that, not cool. But you have to respect the names because most people lost their relatives and never got any remains from their relatives. So these names here are the only remembrance of their loved ones. Yes, we're going to go to the Oculus. Let's go to the Oculus right now. Let me show you guys the Oculus. Let's walk past the survivor tree again. I love this. This is like so cool looking. It's like the only tree blooming right now. So neat. So cool. Yeah, weather in July really kind of, it could be anything from really, really hot to really, really nice and pleasant. Definitely humid. It could definitely get humid in July. But a lot of stuff is going on in New York City in July, so that's why you want to come down. Yes, they do keep it extremely clean. They close it up overnight. So they do clean it up overnight. What we're going to do is we're going to go over here. We'll go over here. We're going to walk right past the tridents right now of the old World Trade Center here. They saved some of the facade from the original Twin Towers, and it's just behind glass here, right here in the entrance to the museum. And I highly recommend coming to the museum. Just buy your tickets online to avoid the lines here in person. Look at that. Look at the architecture right here. Like the striking line with the glass, and then right into the Oculus here. It's kind of amazing. So we really can't see the tridents. I want to show you guys the tridents, but it's too much glare. Here's the North Tower. Let's walk over here. This is seriously like, you know, the New York Post especially has given a lot of hate to this structure. I think this is going to be one of the greatest structures in New York City around. It's going to be the new Grand Central Station, I think. Let me get you guys. Wow, look at the line here. The line is kind of nuts. I'm trying to keep people out of the shot here. Just to show you guys what it looks like, but yeah, a lot of people here today. It's usually not tourist season. You'll be staying near the Flatiron Building, awesome. The Arm Iron Building or the Flatiron Building? You're staying near 23rd Street? Yes, we're gonna actually, I'll try to get inside the Oculus. I know there's a dead zone of cell phone zone right there, so I may have to stop and start the broadcast again. Yes, Flatiron Building, if you're staying up by 23rd Street. But this is not the Flatiron Building, this is the Oculus. So I'm gonna tell you guys the concept behind this building here. Designed by Santiago Calatrava. Why did it cost $4 billion? Cost $4 billion because it's basically three construction sites on top of each other. You have the PATH station, you have the museum, and then you have the memorial. And each piece had to be completed in order for another piece to begin construction. Add Hurricane Sandy, throwing in a couple of million gallons of water into the site, and that's why it costs so much. Is that supposed to look like a bug? Think of a dove spreading its wings, beginning flight. And that's what Santiago Calatrava was going for. And actually, these wings here were going to be a little bit longer than they are. They actually shortened them a bit. Yes, in 2012, this was very much a construction site, and it still is very much a construction site. We're right here on Greenwich Street. And Greenwich Street will reintroduce the grid plan to the super block created in the original World Trade Center. This is where number 2 World Trade Center will be. And you gotta keep in mind, the number 2 World Trade Center will be almost as tall as number 1 World Trade Center. As we come around here, I'll look straight up for you guys. So beginning with number 1 World Trade Center, as we come around the memorial, each building will get shorter and shorter. So number 3 will be a little bit shorter, number 4 is a little shorter, and then off in that direction will be number 5. We're skipping number 6 World Trade Center, just to let you know. You were here on St. Paddy's Day, was extremely awesome. Yes, the view at the top of the transit hub is amazing. I actually took an Instagram from there. Yes, number 2 will be 1,340 feet tall, yes. That's up, kind of up in the air right now, though. It's kind of up in the air, because we don't know what the final design is going to be. They recently changed the design, but then the person who made them change the design decided to back out of the plan. That's the News Corporation. So, yeah, we don't know what's going on with number two right now. It's kind of annoying. But this thing is going to be amazing when it's fully completed. Now, I'm going to take you guys in there in a little bit, but what unfortunately, we have to go through kind of crazy corridors here. So I'm going to attempt to hopefully keep you guys connected. I may have to restart the scope just to let you guys know. But number one World Trade Center, 1,776 feet tall, 542 meters, 104 floors. Underneath the communications rings, that's the original height of the old Twin Towers, 1,379 feet. Ooh, and the sun just came out. Look at that. Kind of amazing. All right. Yes, Rockefeller, I love Rockefeller Center. Restarts, I could give a ton. No, you can keep on giving hearts as much as the broadcast, as long as the broadcast is on. You could just keep tapping that screen. And you can just keep on going, giving me hearts. Thank you so much. I want to get near a million hearts. All right, so we're going to walk past the entrance to the museum here. So the museum is based on time tickets. So it'll tell you what time to get here if you order your tickets online. And you won't have to wait in line too long. Same thing goes for the observation deck, which I got a scope from there eventually. Do I live in New York? I come from Brooklyn. I live in Brooklyn. Born and raised. Increasingly becoming an anomaly here in New York. So what we're going to do is, in order to get inside the Oculus, we have to walk through the concourse of number 4 World Trade Center. So that's what we're going to do right now. Like Florida. Yeah, it's kind of nuts over here. The line, I've never seen the line this long before. And Yes, One World Observatory is amazing. Temperature is around, 55? It's nice. It's nice. And today will be a whole day's worth of periscopes. After this, we will go, I will walk onto the Brooklyn Bridge. I'll start the scope from the Brooklyn Bridge. We'll be directly in the middle of the bridge. So here's, we're walking down Greenwich Street right now, which is currently closed. I don't think this street will ever be open to regular traffic. Been up to the top 3 times already. Oh, so cool. I was up there one time for a tourism deal, and I wasn't allowed to take any pictures or Instagrams. So it was really frustrating, but the elevator ride up and down was so unforgettable. Yeah, a few people wearing t-shirts. And when the sun comes out, it's a little bit warm. Warm enough to wear just a t-shirt. This is where the new Greek Orthodox Church is going to be, right here on this corner here. That Greek Orthodox Church, look up the renderings for it. It's going to be another absolutely beautiful building. Oh, you scoped 2 and you got 1 on YouTube. Awesome. Check out Jim's videos. Redstone Soldier. Yeah. Look at that. So cool. So let's, we're going to walk into the Oculus now. Again, I may lose the signal. But we'll see. This is like a test for me right now, too. This is a test for me as it's 2:40 Eastern Time, -5 GMT. It is beautiful. So here is Ladder 10, Engine 10, the Tribute Center. The pizza place across the street's okay. I recommend the place around the corner a little bit better. This Burger King was here before 9/11 and is still here after. Hello from Dublin. You're more than welcome for the scope. And what's his name? Russell Simmons' old apartment was right here in that tan building. You could smell the New York City air. Yeah. You could smell the New York City air. Hello from the UK. Malden. Thanks for tuning in. Welcome to the World Trade Center. We're going to make our way into the Oculus. And then I'll end the broadcast back out in front of the Survivor Tree. Because that's what this broadcast is titled, after all. All right. So now we're going to go hello from France. We're going to walk into number 4 World Trade Center now. So let's see how the signal holds up.
Let's see how the signal holds up. Hopefully the signal holds up good. So this is the transit entrance inside number 4. The key thing with the New World Trade Center, everything is white, everything is marble. It even smells like, you could smell the new paint in here right now. I always like to think, hello from Sochi, Russia. How was the Olympics? Look at this. Everything is white. Good so far. Thanks, Jim. Everything is white. Everything is clean. Oh, yeah. You live 8 miles away. I live about 8 miles away, too. I live in Bay Ridge. Bay Ridge, Brooklyn. Look at all this white marble. So cool. Okay, so now, let's see, South Main Course, One World, we're gonna go, some of it's open to the public, not all of it. Hello from Moscow, thanks for tuning in. We're gonna go this way. Oh yeah, here we go. I remember where it is now. Bivret Russia, Bivret Russia. This is all gonna be stores in this corridor right here. We're walking over to the path entrance right now. Kind of reminds me of an airport. And you see all the ribs here. It's like beginning the whole experience of being here. Yeah, it looks like I have a good...
We're... Now, your attention, please. We are working hard to keep you safe on path every day.
Okay. This is... Oh, we're inside. We're underneath number 4 World Trade Center. Thanks for the update on the video. Okay. Here we go. This is going to be a mall. Hello to Michael. Thanks for tuning in. Where are you guys watching? These are all going to be stores here. These are all going to be stores. So it is going to be like a mall.
While traveling on the PATH system, Canada
I gotta see, I got a temporary wall still up here. This will be the second level of the mall right here. But now we're gonna go. Now look at this! This is so wild. It's like a dream.
On train and in station areas.
See, yes, pass only, but the subway lines will be all connected eventually. I'll describe it once I'm in the middle of the Oculus here. It is massive. Look at this. Welcome to the Oculus, folks. Welcome, welcome, welcome. And there's number 1 World Trade Center. There we go. It is really beautiful. So in this direction here, this is where you come out of the path. And this is the only section that's open right now. So you could go into this direction here and you could get to the path, number 1 World Trade Center, and number 7 World Trade Center. Nobody in NASA's career. Oh, Jeremy? Yeah, I love the American flag, me too. And then this is the second level. This is the level we were just on, is right there. Those are more shops. This whole area here will be lined with shops. We gotta have an Apple store. There's gonna be, oh my God, there's like a whole list of crazy tour attendants are gonna be here. Italy's gonna come here. So what we're gonna do is, here's a really cool elevator I can't wait to ride. Yes, the 1 train will stop here. We'll connect to the R, and then it'll connect to the Fulton Street Transit Hub down the block. So it's all gonna be one long corridor, and it ends right here. Look at that elevator. The elevator's like wild. I can't wait to ride it. But now let's look this way. This is probably the picture that you've seen in all the TV and news. And we got Coney Island Baby tuned in. Thanks for tuning in, Marissa. This is an amazing place. Look at this. So this is how it works. In this direction here, we're looking towards the Fulton Street Transit Hub, the 456 train, and the NR train. The NR train's closest to us. It's literally just behind that wall right there. Yeah, it looks Star Trek-y. Yeah. And the skylight here in the middle opens up. and it's going to be opened up only on September 11th every year. But how it works is that this skylight is lined up with a very important mark, because it creates what they call the wedge of light. On September 11th, between 8:46 in the morning and 10:30 in the morning, a wedge of light will come through this skylight here, unbothered. It'll come through completely clean through all the buildings, and a beam of light will basically come across the entire site here through that time. I have a feeling they're going to do the memorial ceremonies here for the families, because this kind of reminds me of like a church. But that's what's going to happen. It creates look it up, wedge of light. And it's going to be amazing. You know, some naysayers say that some of the new construction blocks it, but it actually doesn't. It's on a very specific angle here. It was supposed to be parallel with Fulton Street, but then when Daniel Libeskind saw that all you had to do was rotate it about 40 degrees, that's what they did. They rotated it 40 degrees. Hello. To line it up with the sun alignment for September 11th. It does kind of look like an ice skating rink, yeah. And that's what everyone does. Everyone like gets on the floor. They want to take, you know, they want to look straight up, take pictures. It's warm in here, I'll tell you that much. From Assisi? Thanks. Thanks for tuning in. But this is the transit hub. This is going to be, and designed by Santiago Calatrava. And if I haven't explained it already, from Russia, awesome. But they didn't describe it already. Why did it cost $4 billion? One, because of the design. The design is very ambitious. Because these ribs here, something like almost 300 of these ribs here. These are like massive steel ribs that weigh many, many tons and tons of pounds. You're more than welcome. Thanks. I had to keep my periscopes interesting. Like, it's designed for like the worst. You have to remember that. They designed everything for worst case scenario here. Thanks for mentioning this on Twitter. So that's the first part. The materials were expensive. The design was expensive. And then again, it's three construction sites on top of each other. We're on top of the PATH train, the memorial, and then the concourses here. So we are underground already. We're underground right now. But look at how the light, this is my first time coming here. The last time I was here really early in the morning and it was a cloudy day. So we didn't have this much light coming through, but look at all the light coming through. It's really amazing. And then everything being white is, yes, this design is definitely 10 to 20 years ahead. It definitely is. That's why I can't stand when people hate it. Look at how everyone comes out of the path right here. You can see how the foot traffic works right now. And eventually, when it's complete, they'll be walking straight towards us, going to the subway. It's okay. You don't have to speak really good English. You can just take in the sights. See how everyone coming off the path? And then they're going to go right through that concourse because it's open. But eventually, they'll be able to go straight and onto Fulton Street. And then from here, they'll connect to the 456. Oh, look, there's a bird in here. Holy cow, we got the first pigeon in here. We're inside the Oculus right now at the World Trade Center. This is called the Transit, also known as the Transit Hub. Look at how the light is coming through here. Yes, this is steel. This is a steel covered in a really unique fireproofing. So it almost feels like stone, but it's straight up steel and really thick steel at that. We're inside the World Trade Center and we're inside the Transit Hub right now. Yeah, I wonder if they planned on for birds too. You know, considering that they opened this, that they had to have kind of gotten ready for birds, but I wasn't expecting a bird to be in here now. Considering there's so much construction going on. There's construction going on over there. That PATH station is a temporary PATH station, so that's going to be slightly moved. There's construction all around here. There's construction on the other side of Fulton Street here. These are all stores. Yes, this is glass. This is a special kind of glass. This is a special blast-proof glass that, in case, God forbid, anything were to happen, the glass will break up into such small pieces, it wouldn't hurt you. So, and then everything else is straight-up steel. A treated steel with special fireproofing on it, so it feels like stone almost. And because everything's white, light just bounces off of everything. It's kind of amazing. Thanks for sharing this on Facebook again. It is, and you can see, here's number 3 World Trade Center peering in, right above us. Exactly, that's what Santiago Calatrava was going for with all the ribs here. He was going for a light look, but believe me, this is not light. This is highly over-engineered. Thanks for sharing me all over the internet. Thanks for sharing this on Twitter. Yeah, I know. You know, the negative reviews are because they were, you know, basically describing the building before it was even finished. And it's still not even nowhere near finished. But they didn't understand the concept and the design of it, which is bring natural light down into the subway. Some 60 feet underground, mind you. Thanks for inviting your followers, Jim. And thanks for sharing this on Twitter, Alberto. You're more than welcome. You're more than welcome. This is what my Periscopes are all about, to take you guys to New York City. I was supposed to work today. It rained this morning, so I got rained out. Thanks for sharing this on Twitter. Thanks for inviting your followers, Jack Sparrow. Don't you love New York? Me too. Look at that. So neat. It's like almost abstract. And everyone just looks up. That's what I love about it. Everyone just looks up. So you imagine, like, you're coming home, right? You're coming to work, right? Oh, you're more than welcome, yeah. Imagine you're coming to work, right? Coming to work from New Jersey. You're coming out, dark, train station. It's going to be light too, but it's not going to be like this. And then you come out, and then you see this. I mean, what a great way to start your day at work. Seriously, this is one of, like, the best designs, I think, ever. I mean, again, this is going to be the new Grand Central Station of New York City. When all the shops are open, when you could get a sandwich in here, when you could get an iPad in here, what else is going to be? Like, a Burberry is going to open up in here, and a whole bunch of stuff's opening up here. Super modern design. Yes, the PATH train. The PATH train is right over here. That takes you into New Jersey underneath the Hudson River. And then eventually the corridor will open up all the way so that you could walk underground, avoid the Memorial Plaza, and you'll be able to connect to all the ferries that go to New Jersey. So that's all opening up as we speak. That will take you all the way down to Brookfield Place, formerly known as the World Financial Center. So remember, this week here, we're looking west in this direction here. Exactly. You want to just take a breath and just take it in. And then in this direction here, we're looking down towards Fulton Street, and the NR trains and the 456 trains at Fulton, the Fulton Transit Center. And I believe, what, the A and the C go there too? I always forget what trains go to the Fulton Street Center, but a lot of trains do. So cool. So happy you guys are liking this. This is what my Periscopes are all about. All right, so let's go back. I want to stay in here because look at the light here is shifting. So the PATH trains run 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Very seldomly they get shut down. Probably only for construction. They may shut down from the World Trade Center. You'll have to go to Midtown or vice versa. We'll take one more look here and then we'll go back topside and we'll finish again at the Survivor Tree here. But this is just like the coolest thing. I can't wait to be up that on that perch right there. That's going to be an amazing picture when you're up on that perch there. You need a really wide lens to take this in. If you do come here with a nice camera, get a nice like fisheye lens. Yeah, we're gonna go see the tree right now. Let's go see the tree. Cooking dinner, talk later. Thanks for sharing this out, Ryan. So let's go back to the Survivor Tree. And we'll end the broadcast there. But later on, we're going to go onto the middle of the Brooklyn Bridge in a few minutes. And we'll people watch from the middle of the Brooklyn Bridge. Okay, so the Survivor Tree used to stand in between the original number 4 and number 5 World Trade Center. It survived both collapses. They nursed it back to health. And then they brought it back to the Memorial Plaza here. And when you see the Survivor Tree right now, you're going to love it. Because it's the only tree blooming in the entire Memorial Plaza. And it looks amazing. I came down here just to take some Instagrams of it and to take pictures of it. Okay, yeah. Wait until you see this tree. This is gonna be so cool. So we're back here in the concourse. This is the upper concourse again. It's a peach tree. All the other trees in the memorial are white swamp oak trees. Yes, the old cathedral, St. Paul's Chapel, always looks amazing. And of course, further down the block is Trinity Church at Wall Street and Broadway. Beautiful scope, thank you. Do we already have leaks? It is a complex structure, so. Oh, you're a Georgia peach, awesome. Also the survivor, awesome. All right, now, can't go up this way because this is like the business entrance to number 4 World Trade Center. So we gotta go around. But this will be all lined with shops when it's completed. So now I know I could periscope down here. Thanks for following me, Georgia peach. I love Georgia. I love Savannah. Savannah is one of the only cities of the world that I would move to. So I loved Savannah. I was able to ride my bike around there, and it had great old streets. Good. Thank you so much. Video is still 5 out of 5. Yes. I love Savannah, Georgia. All right, so one level down right now. We're just going to go up one more level here. Thanks for following me on Twitter. And we're leaving number 4 World Trade Center, and we're making our way up to the memorial. And you'll be here in August, awesome. So this is the transit entrance again to number 4 World Trade Center. August is gonna be hot. August is always really a hot month here in New York. Thanks for sharing this on Twitter. Yeah, we're gonna get to the survivor tree right now, actually. So now we're leaving the transit entrance of underneath number 4 World Trade. What is that, Norway? What's up, Norway? Norway or Sweden? That's Sweden, yeah, Sweden. Yeah, that's Sweden. Norway's red. All right. Ooh, it's really hot down there. We're back outside on Liberty Street right now. If you were here when the old World Trade Center was here, this is where the Sam Goody used to be. Yeah, it was close. Yeah, Sweden. Sorry about that. The fire department house here, engine ladder 10. I believe they lost all of their workers on that day, on 9/11. Don't know too much about it. Thanks for mentioning this on Twitter. 343 firefighters lost their lives on 9/11. Hello! So here we are. Thanks for mentioning this on Twitter again. I am a native New Yorker. I'm from Brooklyn. Born and raised. If you've seen the movie Saturday Night Fever, you have seen my house. All right. So now we're going to cross Greenwich Street again. Let's look up at number 1 again. Look at that. Look at that. So cool. Yeah, if you watch the scene where they talk about getting out of the neighborhood, something I never did. So can you see that tree blooming all by itself off in the distance? That's a survivor tree. So the memorial consists of, if you didn't hear it earlier, it's around 270-something white swamp oak trees. And then we have the one survivor tree, which stood between the old number 4 and number 5 World Trade Center. We were here in November. Awesome. But I saw this picture this morning on Twitter. It's not cold at all, but inside the transit hub, it's really, really warm. Very somber, yes. Can you see it? We gotta get closer to it. But I love how it's just literally all by itself blooming. I saw this morning on Twitter and I was like, oh, I gotta get down here and take Instagrams. So that's what I did. And I could show you guys it too. Okay. I love the survivor tree. It's a peach tree. We brought it back to health out in Van Cortlandt Park. Yes, it's gonna be really cold and really windy tonight, yes.
Not looking forward to the cold and wind. The cherry blossoms are blooming in Central Park. And I do have a Periscope where we did a cherry blossom special in Prospect Park. So check that, Central Park. So check that out on my catch page. Let's get to this here. So usually New Yorkers just get out of my way. Tourists just kind of... But the tourists are my bread and butter. I'm a licensed New York City tour guide, so I gotta love the tourists. 58 million. Thanks for inviting your followers. 58 million visited New York last year. And there she is. That's our survivor tree. Isn't that cool? It's literally the only tree blooming. So where it used to be right over there, where number 3 World Trade Center is beginning to rise. And it is huge. She is. She's around almost 30 feet tall. Nurse her back to health. It is very special. Hello from Russia. Okay, let me back up a little bit here. I want you guys to really take it in because it's so cool looking. All right, it's a Georgia peach. I mean, it's like the only color right now. It's so cool. And as the sun comes out, let's look back up at number 1 World Trade Center. Look at that. Just coming out. It's like the city of the future. Look at that survivor tree. I love the survivor tree. So my rules for visiting the World Trade Center. 1, don't lean on the names. Don't lean on the names at the Memorial Plaza. Because that's kind of disrespectful. Don't sit on the names either. Don't take smiling pictures in front of the memorial pools, please. Don't do that either. If you want to pose in front of something, pose in front of the survivor tree. And she's special for literally the only one blooming. I mean, it's like none of the other trees have anything going on them right now. It's kind of amazing. And I've seen pictures of this in the past, but when I saw it on Twitter this morning, I was like, I gotta come down here and see that. So yeah, how did she survive 9/11? What happened was, when the buildings collapsed, they found her a month later, or almost 2 months later in November. And again, right over here where number three is rising. And some of the construction workers found her, and they were like, my God, this tree is still alive. The leaves are still on it, and it's still coming out. So they saved it. And they brought it first to Van Cortlandt Park in the Bronx. They nursed it back to health. And then they brought it out to Pennsylvania. And look at the light bouncing off of it right now. So beautiful. And then it was brought back here about, 2 years ago now? And it has its own watering system and its own everything. Thanks for inviting your followers. And it's kind of amazing. So it stands out amongst all these other swamp oak trees here. This kind of creates color here. As people look at me funny, talking into the... Yes, it does. Yes, it does. Come here in the summertime. And they actually had to tell people, don't pick the peaches off the tree. It's not a good thing. Sorry about that. They tell people, don't pick the peaches off the tree. It does look awesome. So I'm standing right here next to number two World Trade Center. This is the South Tower here. So if I didn't describe to you it before, if you weren't here earlier, so we have the names here. The names here are put together by company that they worked for, and for co-workers and the floor that they worked on and the company they worked for. That's how they're kind of comprised here. You want to pay tribute, just do that. This is what I recommend doing. This is what it's kind of designed for. Just run your fingers on the names here. If you see a flower, please don't take the flower. Don't lean on the names. Don't sit on the names. And, of course, don't take selfies in front of you. That's kind of rude. But this pool here goes down some 60 feet. Yeah, there are people who do that. There are people who do. I've seen people do so many horrible, disrespectful things here. I saw 9/11 from a roof, just to guys, let you guys know. I watched the whole thing. Yes, you can take pictures. I recommend taking pictures. Take pictures, yes. But again, it's like in MoMA, they tell people don't pose in front of the artwork. Don't pose in front of the names here.
We know you're here, so just take a picture of it, you know? But if you do want to pose in front of something, pose in front of this. Pose in front of the survivor tree. This you could smile in front of all you want. This is what I like to tell people to do. Yeah, you gotta show respect. I've seen people, yeah, that's not cool. It's not something to sit on. But yeah, you could just get the whole family in front of it. Hello from the Ukraine, thanks for tuning in. Oh yeah, 2000, right? Wasn't it amazing? U.S. Army veteran, exactly. Yeah, I know. I know. The survivor tree does look amazing. This is why I was here, came out here, just to show you guys this. It is, it's hopeful, you know, it's a living memorial. As you know, Michael Arad is the architect of the whole memorial here. And that's what he wanted it to be. He wanted it to be a living memorial where people just, you know, hang around, sit, have lunch. I don't know about workers having lunch right now, but it is overrun with tourists. But don't do that. See that? Don't do that. You don't want to do that. Look at some of the names here. Engine 33, Engine 6, Ladder 9. Again, 343 firemen lost their lives here. In total, 2,794 people lost their lives here. I actually knew two people who worked right here in the South Tower. They both saved their own lives. Yes, 343 firefighters. 41 Port Authority police officers and another, I believe, 22 NYPD officers. And they did this here. This is a major engineering here. This is a lot of water. In this pool alone, it's 120 gallons a minute is recycled. Thanks for following me. Yeah, I always give quality scopes like this. But this is goes straight down here. And again, this is where the building would be, right here. See where it rises up right here? The building's wall would be right here. So think of the memorial names as a pedestal for the original number one World Trade Center and number two, the twin towers of the World Trade Center. It does, right? It's intentionally supposed to look like that. It's the void. So you can't see exactly where it goes. We'll go to the North Tower right now. And thanks for mentioning this on Twitter and inviting your followers. Yes, it's called the void. Thanks for serving our country for 3 years. So I knew two friends who made it out of the South Tower. They both saved their own lives because basically what happened was when the North Tower got hit, you're more than welcome for sharing this. When the North Tower got hit, they had south-facing offices. So they didn't see the explosion and the impact, but they felt it. So they were both here for the 1993 bombing, and they were decided to be like, you know what, we're going to get out of here. And the management came over the PA system and told people in the South Tower to stay put. The tower was secure. Little did they know there was another plane on the way. So I had two friends, one on the 97th floor and one on the 65th floor. The 65th floor was one of the impact floors for the South Tower. My friend, she worked for a small law firm on the 65th floor. She decided to get her co-workers and they decided to just go down immediately. They went down. And my friend lives in Brooklyn Heights, so she used to ride her bike to work. She saw the South Tower get hit from the Brooklyn Bridge. My friend on the North Tower, on the 97th floor of the South Tower, he actually cleaned his office, got his best friend who worked in the same commodities exchange firm together, and they decided to get an early lunch at 9 o'clock in the morning. So they were on the corner of Liberty and Church Street when the South Tower got hit. So it was kind of crazy. But this is the North Tower right here. Don't know which company these guys work for. I'm going to show you something, a bit of a memorial within the memorial here. So there used to be a memorial for the 1993 bombing. Eddie. My first name is Eddie. You can call me Dutch, though. Let's look back at the Oculus again. Look at the Oculus, so cool looking. How much is it to go up? It's $31 to go up, but it's highly recommended. Yeah, Dutch is cool too. Yeah, Dutch is like my nickname. Let's, can we get to the, that'd be too many people over there. Along the names here, they kind of merged the 1993 memorial with the memorial pools here. So on one of the panels here are the names of the six people who died in 1993. How much does it cost to come back? Round trip, $31 round trip up and down. So now we're right in front of number one World Trade Center here. And wow, there's a lot of people out here. See how they're posing? Don't pose in front of it. I don't recommend posing in front of it, but we'll take a moment of silence here because we have some flowers here. Whenever you see flowers here, that signifies one of two things. It's either a birthday, an anniversary of some sort. But don't pick up. I've seen people take the flowers away, and that just drives me nuts. It's fun holding. We'll zoom out here. Sorry about that, guys. There we go. Let me get right up on this here. With the survivor tree. See the survivor tree off in the background there. Yes, the Ellis Island wall is amazing. So let me see if I can find the panel here. The panel for the 1993 bombing here. I don't think I can. There is a computer of sorts that tells you where to find your name. You see, the panels are all numbered and lettered, so you could find your loved one rather easily. It is moving. Well, I think I see it. So I always feel the need. Whenever I come close to some names sometimes, I always like to say, like, you know, show them a little love. Have your name, run your name over it. The wall here, this is 40 feet high, but then the void goes all the way down to 60 feet. So it's really, really, again, it's quite an engineering feat. The amount of water that goes... gets recycled in both of the towers here is equivalent to almost a quarter of the total amount of water that goes over Niagara Falls. You get drawn to them. So this is the night for the 1993 bombing right here. And these are all the people. These are all the people who died in 1993 right here. Kind of amazing. Flight 11 is coupled right here. Flight 11 is actually kind of in the same wall where they impacted. So that's how they're all clustered here. Yeah, many, many, many people. Almost 300 countries were affected. But we move on here in New York. We always rebuild. Let's look up at number one World Trade Center. Look at that view. Really sad. Sorry to hear that. It's amazing. And my zip code in Brooklyn was the most affected zip code in the city. Yes, we kind of belong to the world. That's why I love showing it off to people. You're more than welcome. Yeah, Arlington National Cemetery. Yeah, that's incredibly powerful also. Right in front of us are the pump houses for the memorial pools. Just scoped here on Thursday. Awesome. So we're going to go back to the survivor tree. We'll end there. And then in a few minutes, I'll come back online, and we'll be in the middle of the Brooklyn Bridge. It's New York Day on my Periscope here, so we'll be on the Brooklyn Bridge next, And then at the end of the day, we'll be down in Coney Island. We're going to ride a roller coaster, and we'll watch the sunset, hopefully, if the sun comes out. So full day of periscopes. Yes, question. Yes, please. I am a licensed New York City tour guide. That's my job. Please ask me questions. You want to see me? All right. Well, I'll show you guys me when we get to the survivor tree. I'll turn the camera around. Thanks. Try to keep my. I was in radio for like 2 seconds. The trees have symbolism. The trees were picked because they bloom roughly at the same time. So that's what they picked. It's like a uniform look with the trees. The benches do not have any major significance, though. They're just kind of there. Again, it's to create that living memorial where people just hang out. They sit. You know, the trees aren't in any kind of order. They're just kind of placed in rows. Captured audience from India. Thanks for tuning in, India. Look at this beautiful, beautiful tree. It was supposed to rain today. It rained this morning. But thank God it didn't rain. It's not going to rain, I think, for the rest of the day. So I'll be able to go down to Coney Island and ride the road. Because, yes, 343 firefighters died here. All right. We got to go. Let's get right underneath our survivor tree here. Yeah, the roller coaster will be near sunset. So get ready for that. Look at this. How beautiful this is. I'm so happy I got to see this. I got to show all you guys this. Give you guys another spin around here. Number 3 World Trade Center under construction. Number 4 in the void here. This will be where number 2 World Trade Center will be. Museum entrance. The tree has been here before. The tree was here. It survived both collapses of the World Trade Center. So it's been here since the 1980s? Late 1970s? So it's been here quite some time. It was just over there where number 3 World Trade Center is rising. Look at this. So beautiful. I'm glad you guys enjoyed this. I really wanted to do this and show you guys this. Coming up next, Trump won't run. Don't worry about that. Want to see me? Hey, look at that. Isn't that beautiful? So we're going to go to the Brooklyn Bridge now. So we're going to go to the Brooklyn Bridge, tune in about 15, 20 minutes. I'll be back online. I'll be right in the middle of the bridge. And we'll people watch a little bit on the Brooklyn Bridge. So from the beautiful Brooklyn, we're in World Trade Center, in the beautiful World Trade Center here in Lower Manhattan. Dutch Moss signing off for now. Be back in a little bit. Yeah, I'm not in Brooklyn. We're in World Trade Center, Lower Manhattan. So I'll be back on in a little bit. So stay tuned, folks. And thanks for following me all over. Thank you. You're more than welcome, Zoom, of course. See you in a little bit. I live in Brooklyn, and I'm not poor. I have 3 jobs, but I'm not poor. See you soon, folks.